Chapter 6 of 1001 Questions and Answers on General History. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. Recording by D. Randall. 1001 Questions and Answers on General History by Benjamin Hathaway. Greece. 1. Where is Greece? The most eastern of three peninsulas which extend southward from Europe. 2. How was ancient Greece divided? Into three parts. The first in the north was composed of Thessaly and Epirus, the second in the middle called Hellas, which was the most important part, and the third, the peninsula forming the southern part called Peloponnesus. 3. What can be said of the geographical features of Greece? They had much to do with fixing the character of its inhabitants, the great variety of soil and climate tending to produce a versatile people. 4. Describe the coast of Greece. It is deeply indented with numerous bays, having bold promontories reaching far out to sea and forming excellent harbors. 5. How did that affect the Greeks? It offered them every inducement to a seafaring life. 6. Describe the interior of Greece. The land is cut up by almost impassable mountain ranges. 7. What was the effect upon the people? Each little valley being isolated developed its own peculiar life. 8. Name 4 important mountains in Greece. Olympus, 10,000 feet high. Parnassus, 8,000 feet high. Penteleus, 4,000 feet high. And Hymettus, 3,400 feet high. 9. What is the origin of the Greeks? They belong to the Aryan family and are in close relation to the people of Central Asia. 10. Who were the primitive inhabitants of Greece? The Pelasgians, a simple agricultural people. 11. Who conquered the country? The Hellenes, a warlike race who gave the land its name Hellas. 12. What were the principal cities of Greece? Athens, Sparta, Corinth, and Thebes. 13. When were these cities founded? About 1500 BC. 14. What was the earliest period of Grecian history called? The Heroic Age. 15. Are the events of the Heroic Age authentic? They are not, but are clouded in mystery. 16. When did Grecian mythology originate? During the Heroic Age. 17. Name 2 great traditions of this age: the expedition of the Argos and the Trojan War. 18. Name some noted persons belonging to the Heroic Age: Hercules, Theseus, and Achilles. 19. What is the first clearly defined event of Grecian history? The Dorian migration. 20. What was it? The Dorians, a hardy race from the north, invaded the Peloponnesus and made an entire conquest about the 11th century BC. 21. What is this movement called in history? The return of the Heraclidae, as it was conducted by the descendants of Hercules, who had been banished for more than a century. 22. What was the other leading race in Greece? The Ionians. 23. What were the 2 great centers of Hellenic life? Sparta, the capital of the Dorians, and the Athens, the capital of the Ionians. 24. What change was there in the names of these races? Each was called after its capital, and are known as the Spartans and Athenians. 25. What were the chief characteristics of the Spartans? They were rough and plain in their habits, pitiless, fearless warriors in battle, and were enemies of trade and the fine arts. 26. What were the characteristics of the Athenians? They were refined in their tastes, democratic, commercial, and lovers of music, painting, and sculpture. 27. Who is said to have introduced the alphabet into Greece? Cadmus, who brought it from Phoenicia. 28. Why is the second age called Homeric? Because Homer immortalized this period by his poetry. 29. When did Homer live? sometime between 1000 BC and 870 BC. 30. What are Homer's greatest poems? The Iliad and the Odyssey. 31. What criticism has been offered on the two poems of Homer? That they were not written by one man, but were fragments of old poems collected by different persons. 32. How have they been honored? The cities of Greece owned state copies of his works, which not even the treasures of kings could buy, and his poems were then, as now, the standard classics in the literary education. 33. What great lawgiver lived in this period? Lycurgus. 34. What is said of Lycurgus? He declined the Spartan crown and made the people swear to abide by his laws until his return. Then he left the country and died in another land. 35. How were the people taught by Lycurgus? To speak in short sentences. Hence the laconic style of language. 36. What was the name of Sparta during his rule? Laconier, hence the word laconic. 37. Did the Greeks have any central government? They did not, but necessity caused them to form treaties. 38. What united all Greece in a sacred bond? The four great national games. 39. How long did these games last at a time? For many days, similar to a county or state fair. 40. What were they? Olympic, Pythian, Nemean, and Isthmian. 41. Which was the greatest? The Olympic. 42. Describe the Olympic Games. Held every 4 years at Olympia, races of all kinds were engaged in, the ballads of Homer were recited, and the victor was crowned with a crown of olive or laurel. 43. Who contended in these games? Greeks from all over the world, but no other nations. 44. What effect did these sports have on military operations? All military operations ceased during their continuance. 45. Who founded the Olympic Games? Tradition says Hercules. 46. What is meant by the Olympiad? As this festival occurred so regularly, it was used as a measure of time, the year 776 BC to 772 BC, being the first Olympiad. 47. What two states were the greatest contenders in these games? Athens and Sparta. 48. What was the next festival of importance? The Pythian, in honor of the god Apollo. 49. What was a special feature of the Pythian festival? The contest of poetry, music, and oratory. 50. When was it held? The third year of every Olympiad. 51. Whose honor was celebrated by the Nemean Games? The Greek god Zeus. 52. How often were they held? Every 2 years, near Cleone. 53. Where were the Isthmian Games held? On the Isthmus of Corinth, near the temple of Poseidon, the sea god. 54. What may be said of the Spartans at this time? They became masters of most of their near neighbors and got control of the peninsula. 55. What may be said of Athens, the rival of Sparta? Athens also increased in power and influence. 56. Who gave a code of laws to Athens? Draco. 57. What is said of Draco's laws? That they were written in blood. 58. Why were they thus spoken of? Because of their severity, the smallest offense being punishable by death. 59. What did Draco say in defense of his laws? The smallest crime deserves death, and I can find no heavier penalty for the greatest. 60. Who canceled Draco's severe laws? Solon, who ruled at Athens from 594 to 560 BC. 61. When was the age of tyranny, and why so called? From 650 to 500 BC, because many of the cities were governed by despots. 62. Who founded a public library at Athens? Pisistratus, who ruled from 560 to 527 BC. 63. What institution was devised at this time to prevent future tyranny? Ostracism. 64. What was ostracism? Any citizen could be banished without trial by a vote of the people, each citizen writing the name of the person whom he wished to banish on a shell, called ostracon, 6,000 votes being required against the person to determine his condemnation. 65. What was the original meaning of the word tyrant? It was at first applied by the Greeks to a person who became king in a city where the law did not authorize one. Afterward, the tyrant became cruel, and the word took on the meaning we now give it. 66. Who established a democracy at Athens? Cleisthenes. 67. Where had Greece any colonies? In Asia Minor, Italy, and in Africa. 68. When did Athens become a republic? In the year 510 BC. 69. What effect did this have on the colonies? The Asiatic colonies revolted against Persia, who had lately subdued them. 70. What did the Athenians do for the colonies, and what was the result? They sent assistance, which precipitated the Persian Wars. 71. Why called the Persian Wars? Because for 11 years, the Persians were trying to subdue Greece. 72. Who was ruler of Persia at this time? Darius. 73. Whom did Darius send with the army for the first invasion? His son-in-law, Mardonius. 74. What was the result of this invasion? It was an entire failure, the fleet being wrecked off Mount Athos and a large part of the army drowned. 75. When was the second invasion? In the year 490 BC. 76. Where did the two armies meet? On the plains of Marathon. 77. What was the number of persons in each army? Persians, over 100,000. Athenians, 10,000. An extraordinary disparity. 78. What was the result of the battle? The Persians were defeated and driven to their vessels, and they then sailed away. 79. How is this conflict regarded? As one of the world's greatest battles. 80. Why? If the Persians had seceded, the character of European civilization would have been entirely changed, becoming Asiatic. 81. How many generals were in the Grecian army at the Battle of Marathon? 10, each of whom had command for one day. 82. Name three of the most noted generals: Aristides, Miltiades, and Themistocles. 83. Who was considered the greatest? Miltiades. 84. What did each of the other generals do? They each resigned in favor of Miltiades. 85. What is Miltiades called? The hero of Marathon. 86. What became of Miltiades? He died in prison of wounds received in a treasonable attack on the island of Paros. 87. How long was it until the next invasion? 10 years, 480 BC. 88. Who led the invasion? Xerxes, the son of Darius. 89. How many men had Xerxes? Over 1 million. 90. Where did the armies meet? At the pass of Thermopylae. 91. Who met Xerxes at Thermopylae? Leonidas, with 300 Spartan soldiers. 92. What was the result of the battle? Leonidas and all but 2 of his 300 were slain. 93. How large was Leonidas' entire army? 6,000 persons. 94. Where were they at the Battle of Thermopylae? He had dismissed all but the 300 Spartans and 400 Thespians who were in reserve. 95. What caused his great defeat? The treachery of a Greek who admitted the Persians to a pass. 96. What did Xerxes do next? He pressed on into Greece and burnt Athens. 97. Where was the next battle? A naval one off the Isle of Salamis. 98. What was the result of this battle? a great victory for the Grecians. 99. How long did the battle last? From morning till night. 100. After this engagement, what did Xerxes do? He withdrew and returned to Persia in dismay. 101. Did he take all his army? He left Mardonius with 300,000 men in Thessaly. 102. What became of Mardonius? He was defeated and slain the next year at the Battle of Plati and Mycale. 103. Who were the Grecian generals in the Battle of Plati? Aristide and Pausanias. 104. What effect did these wars have on Persia? No Persian army was ever again seen in Greece. 105. What was Aristides called by his countrymen? The Just, on account of his incorruptible character. Tradition says he was so honest he did not have enough to meet his funeral expenses. 106. Who was the greatest statesman of Athens? Pericles. 107. What is the period in which he lived, sometimes called the Age of Pericles? 108. How long did he direct affairs of Athens? For 40 years, 469 through 429 BC. 109. What is said of his administration? It was the most splendid the Athenians ever had. Art and literature flourished, and the city was embellished with the most magnificent edifices. 110. What military event took place in 431 BC? The long-continued jealousy between Sparta and Athens broke out in war. 111. What was this war called? The Peloponnesian War. 112. Who was the Spartan general in this war? Lysander. 113. What was the result of this war? After 27 years of alternate victories and defeat, Athens fell. 114. What may be said of Sparta? It became the leading city of Greece. 115. How did Sparta govern Athens? By 30 men, sometimes called the 30 tyrants on account of their cruelty. 116. What did Athens do under the 30 tyrants? Began to regain her political principles, and after the Athenians had been ruled 8 months, they overthrew the tyrants and reestablished a democratic government. 117. What great man lived in Athens at this time? Socrates. 118. When was he born? In 468 BC. 119. What crime was Athens guilty of in the year 399 BC? The putting to death of Socrates. 120. Why was he put to death? On the false charge of introducing a new worship to corrupt the youth. 121. On what condition was he offered his life? That he would cease to teach. 122. What great truth did he teach? The immortality of the soul, the beauty and necessity of virtue, and the moral responsibility of man. 123. How was he put to death? He was sentenced to drink a cup of poisoned hemlock, which he took in his prison chamber, surrounded by his friends, with whom he cheerfully conversed till the last. 124. Who were his most eminent disciples? Plato and Xenophon, from whom we derive our knowledge of his doctrines, since he himself committed nothing to writing. 125. What did Plato found? The Academic School of Philosophy, so called because he delivered his lectures in the academic gardens. 126. By what is he best known? By his arguments in regard to the immortality of the soul, he taught that death is to be desired rather than feared. 127. What other great schools of philosophy were founded in the 4th century BC? The Peripatetics, the Epicureans, and the Stoics. 128. Who founded the Peripatetic school? Aristotle, who was a student of Plato. 129. Why so called? Aristotle delivered his lectures while walking up and down the shady porches of the Lyceum, surrounded by his pupils, hence called peripatetics, walkers. 130. What has been the influence of Aristotle's teaching? He, more than any other philosopher, originated ideas whose influence is still felt. The father of logic, the principles he laid down in his study have never been superseded. 131. Who were the Epicureans? The followers of Epicurus. 132. What did Epicurus teach? That the chief end of life is enjoyment. He was strictly moral and taught that virtue is the road to happiness, but his followers so perverted this that Epicurean became a synonym for loose and luxurious living. 133. Who were the Stoics? They were the followers of Zeno. 134. From what was their name derived? The painted portico, Stoa, under which he taught. 135. What was their belief? Pain and pleasure were equally despised by them, and indifference to all external conditions was considered the highest virtue. 136. What is the name of the historic period from 371 to 361 BC? The Theban. 137. Why called the Theban period? Because of the war between the Spartans and Thebans. 138. Who was the leading general of Thebes? Epaminondas. 139. What famous battle was fought? The Battle of Leuctra. 140. What was the result of this battle? The defeat of the Spartans for the first time in their history. 141. When was this battle fought? In the year 371 BC. 142. What did Sparta do after the battle? Sent ambassadors to Athens to solicit aid. 143. How long did Thebes rule Greece? Until the death of Epaminondas in the Battle of Mantinea. 144. When was the Battle of Mantinea fought? In the year 362 BC. 145. What was the result of this battle? With the death of the great leader, the Theban cause died. 146. What effect did these civil and national wars have on Greece? The states were so exhausted that they were not able to withstand a very formidable invasion. 147. Who were the next to invade Greece? The Macedonians. 148. What is this period called? The Macedonian. 362 through 146 BC. 149. Who were the Macedonians? Barbarians who lived just north of Greece. 150. What is meant by barbarians? The Greeks called all people who did not use their language barbarians or babblers. 151. What did the Macedonians say as to their own origin? They claimed to be descendants of Hercules. 152. What privileges did this give them? They were admitted to the Olympic Games. 153. Who was king of Macedon at this time? Philip II, who had been a hostage at Thebes and had learned the arts of war. 154. Was King Philip well educated? He was, and could speak the Greek language with great fluency. 155. What did Philip proceed to do? To make war against the Athenians. 156. What was the result? He defeated the Grecians in the great battle of Chaeronea, August 7, 338 BC. 157. What did the Athenian Congress do? They acknowledged the supremacy of Philip and appointed him to command the Grecian army in their proposed war against Persia. 158. What became of Philip? He was assassinated at a feast at the age of 47 years. 159. Who succeeded Philip? His son, Alexander the Great. 160. How old was Alexander at this time? 20 years. 161. What did the Grecian Congress do? Conferred on Alexander the same power they had on his father. 162. What did Alexander then do? With 35,000 Greeks, he began his march to conquer the world. 163. Was he successful? He was, and became the Oriental monarch. 164. What did he do? He conquered all Persia, and finally Tyre, and built the city of Alexandria near the mouth of the Nile. 165. Where and when did he die? At Babylon, 323 BC, aged 33 years. 166. After his death, what did Greece do? It formed a confederacy of states. 167. Were they successful? They were not, but were still under the control of Macedon. 168. What great event happened to Greece in the year 168 BC? It became a Roman province. 169. What was Greece called by the Romans? The province of Achaia. 170. What great orator lived at this time? Demosthenes, born 385, died 322 BC. 171. Where did Demosthenes live? In Athens. 172. Was he naturally a fine speaker? Was not. Had a weak constitution and defective utterance. 173. Was he wealthy? Was left an orphan at the age of 7 years with some property which was squandered by relatives. 174. How did he become an orator? By striving to regain his property and pleading for his rights before the Athenian courts. 175. Was he successful? At the age of 21, he regained a part of his property. 176. What are his most noted orations? His Philippics. 177. What were the Philippics? Orations against the invasion of Philip. 178. What did the Macedonians do with Demosthenes? They threw him into prison, but he escaped by the aid of friends and remained in exile until the death of Alexander. 179. Did he ever return? He did, but was again sought by the Macedonian king, Antipater. 180. Where did he take refuge? In the temple. 181. Was he captured? He carried with him poison to prevent his capture, and before the officers of Antipater could capture him, he took from his own hand the fatal dose. 182. What is the period from 146 BC to 395 AD called? The Roman. 183. What did the Romans do when they captured Greece? They sacked and burnt the city of Corinth, which had been the capital of the Achaean League, and later Caesar rebuilt it. 184. What may be said of Athens? It continued to be the seat of culture and education, and Roman scholars flocked there for its advantages. 185. How were the Grecians now governed? Entirely by Rome for 541 years. 186. When did Paul visit Greece? About the year 50 AD. 187. Where did he dwell? At Corinth, and followed his occupation of tent making for 2 years. 188. When was the Roman capital removed and where? In the year 330 AD, to Byzantium, a Greek city, after it known as Constantinople, Constantine City. 189. When and how was the Roman Empire divided? In 395 AD, into an Eastern and Western Empire. 190. To which one did Greece belong? On account of location, to the Eastern. 191. What period now begins? The Byzantine, 395 to 1453 AD. 192. What was the condition of Greece for the next 1,000 years? Nothing of importance. A few invasions by Normans and Turks. 193. What finally happened? In 1453, Mohammed II took Byzantium and conquered all Greece. 194. What did Greece then become? A part of the Turkish Empire. 195. What may be said of Greece under the Turks? The people were greatly oppressed and the country but little improved. 196. When was the Greek church established? During the Byzantine period. 197. Has there been any uprising against the Turks? One in 1821, in which Lord Byron, the poet, took sides with the Greeks, but one half the population is said to have perished and large tracts of land were reduced to a desert. 198. What was the result? The independence of Greece was proclaimed in 1822. 199. What countries formed a league to assist Greece? England, Russia, and France. 200. Who is the present king? Prince George. 201. When did he become king? In the year 1863. 202. What was the religion of the ancient Greeks? A mythology which invested every stream, grove, and mountain with gods and goddesses, nymphs, and naiads. 203. How were their deities worshipped? With songs and dance, dramas and festivals, spirited contests and gorgeous processions. 204. Name three great Greek tragic poets: Aeschylus, Sophocles, and Euripides. 205. Name three historians: Herodotus, called the father of history, Thucydides, and Xenophon. 206. Name two great sculptors: Phidias and Praxiteles. 207. What are the three styles of Grecian architecture? Doric, Ionic, and Corinthian, distinguished by the shape of their columns. 208. What celebrated ruin is at Athens? The Parthenon, originally a temple sacred to Pallas Athene, the patron goddess of Athens. 209. What is said of its sculptures? The magnificent sculptures that adorned it were designed by Phidias. Some of them are now in the British Museum and are the finest in existence. End of chapter 6.